Welcome back. We've gotten a judicial order to use a RAM unit. So now we'll be able to get into that house rather than just knock on the door helplessly. At least that's the idea. So far, we haven't proven if it's gonna work yet. So, back to the house one more time. And there we are. The RAM unit should already be here. And they are. Thanks to Judge Simpson, the RAM is in place and ready to go. I got the back, Sonny. Keep your hat down. Your backup officer is in position. A RAM is a fortified military vehicle that's been converted for police work and fitted with a steel hydraulic boom. It can get through just about anything. Good, that should make short work of this door. Now, what we need to do in order to get inside is stand at the side of the door and draw our gun. Wait until I'm in position, then take out the door. Yeehaw, there we go. The dog seems unperturbed. It continues barking happily. I'll stay alert. This could be a dangerous situation. Ooh! Got him! Freeze! Don't shoot, I give up! Who's he? Let's take a look. A second suspect is surrendering. It takes you a moment to realize it's. It's Michael Baines. Got the bastard. Scuff him. You feel a sense of satisfaction as you slip the cuffs off on the wrists of Michael Baines. Yeah, I can understand that. I'll take it from here, Sonny. Good, we got the second attacker of Marie. At least we think he's a second attacker. The man you shot is dead. And this time nobody cares whether you shot first or not. Anything else in here? Can we go where he came from? No. So let's see what's in here. You don't have time for that now. She's from December, if you remember correctly. I'm sure Marie would be interested to hear that you know that so well. A large fireplace dominates the room. The old couch has a few cushions on it. Anything under the cushions? Spare change? There's nothing under that cushion. How about this one? You look underneath the filthy cushion and find a remote control. For the TV, I bet. Anything on? No. What about number 5? No. Number 8. Ooh! Part of the fireplace has moved away to reveal a hidden staircase. Who the funk? Let's head downstairs. Looks like a drugs lab. The basement is a seedy-looking place with all the aroma of a drug lab. The shelves have various supplies. The table is covered with various tools to make drugs. Okay, well, let's proceed with caution. Draw our gun again. See what's over on this side. The barrels contain chemicals to make drugs. Oh. Doesn't look like we can go over here, so... Let's see if there's anything else here. Oh! Got him! Hey, Pat! There you are. You shot him! Hold on while I check his vital signs. So she is on our side. Ooh! Or not. I'd like to say it was fun, Buns, but you've been a real pain in my ass, you male pig! Ooh! I'm Detective Hooks, Internal Affairs. We've been keeping an eye on her since your report. Lucky I was here. Congratulations! You've not only solved your murder case, but you've also found and incapacitated a dangerous cult that was processing crack. Now all that's left is to fight the paperwork. You almost welcome the routine of it all. There is such a thing as too much excitement. Indeed. We've done it! We nearly got killed by Pat, though. Fortunately, this guy from Internal Affairs was there. And if we hadn't found the cocaine, if we hadn't alerted the captain, that wouldn't have happened and we would have been dead. Back to the hospital to check up on Marie, I guess. But for now, let the cleanup crew do their job and the guilty sleep their dreamless sleep. For you, there's suddenly nothing more important than Marie. I don't think I'll ever be able to look at you again without feeling what I feel right now. Without remembering what a miracle it is, just to hold you. Speaking of miracles, Dr. Powers has just given me a bit of news. Oh, Sonny. We're going to have a baby! A baby? Oh, wow! LPD recently received this top-secret list of the names and occupations of the members of an alleged electronic terrorist group. The gang leader, one Jim Pretty Boy Walls, has been known to threaten to shape Lytton's future like so much silly putty. It is not known at this time if the gang's intentions are for good or evil, or if they should even be taken seriously. Nevertheless, be on the lookout for the following gang members that are wanted for questioning. And it's the credits! We finished the game! Yes, and as I said before, we have only 450 points, because I have no idea where the remaining 10 points are. And it seems neither does anyone else, because every walkthrough I could find on the internet has only 450 points. Either there's a glitch in the game and there are no more than 450 points, or it's a puzzle that no one knows the solution to. And so, Sonny Bonds' last adventure comes to an end. Jim Walls left Sierra and Daryl F. Gates took over the reins for Police Quest, producing one more traditional adventure game before moving on to the successful Police Quest SWAT series. Sonny makes a cameo as the instructor in SWAT 4, and I believe Marie makes a brief appearance in SWAT 3, but other than that, Sonny's adventures are over. Police Quest 3 combines elements of both its predecessors. It starts with routine traffic duty, like Police Quest 1, and then moves on to detective work, like Police Quest 2. The game is also the most realistic of the series, probably the most realistic game Sierra ever made. It is more difficult than the previous games as well. Like I said before, I used a walkthrough when I played through this game the first time because of my lacking English skills at the time. But even if I had played this game for the first time today, I seriously doubt I would have been able to finish it without hints. Definitely not in one attempt, that's for sure. It's just too easy to forget some small details so that Marie doesn't wake up or Pat kills you at the end, and then you have to backtrack through the entire game to find out where you did something wrong, which I imagine would get very frustrating. But then, almost all Sierra games are like that, and Police Quest 3 certainly isn't the worst one. King's Quest 5, released a year earlier, was much, much worse in this respect. The story of the game is pretty good. We can gather several different plot threads, Marie's coma, the cult murders, and Morales' issues. My only real complaint about the story is that it was a bit unnecessary. Police Quest 2 tied up all the loose ends pretty well, so Bane suddenly having a brother feels like a bit of a stretch. The cult element was also pretty superfluous, but it was still a decent send-off for Sony. Lucius 3 is a worthy addition to the series, and it's a shame that Sonny's adventures had to end here. Police Quest 4 wasn't nearly as good, unfortunately. So, there you have it. Thanks for watching, and goodbye!
I shot the sheriff, but I swear it was in self-defense. I shot the sheriff, but I swear it